Mic check one. Thank you. Good evening, I am Riley Giles, the president of class of 2022.
And I am Martin Ponce, student body president.
Before we all begin, will all current and former members of our military please stand to be recognized?
We thank you for coming to our graduation. We have planned a formal ceremony, and we appreciate your support in making this a special evening for us.
Will you please stand for the national anthem and remain standing until
say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight? O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
and now the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag, to the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome you and thank you for coming to share this commencement ceremony with us. We consider you the parents, family members, and friends a special part of this occasion. Your presence here adds to our ceremony. Palo Verde would also like to extend a warm welcome to Tucson Unified School District's Regional Superintendent Brian Lambert. The class of 2022 thanks everyone for your support, cooperation, and most of all for being here with us tonight. We do ask that you please remain in your seats for the entire ceremony. At the conclusion of our ceremony, we will open the gates to the football field for you to join your graduate. I would like to thank our faculty and staff for support of our seniors, and a special thank you to my administrative team, including Kevin Amidon, the new principal at Sabino High School, Scott Eisenberg, the interim assistant principal in charge of curriculum and instruction, and Michelle Weisbrod, assistant principal of operations and activities, for their hard work in making this evening possible. And now to the class of 2022. It is my honor and privilege to have served you as principal of Palo Verde High Magnet School. On behalf of the entire Palo Verde community, please accept our heartfelt congratulations on graduating this evening. Your accomplishments in and out of the classroom, on the field, court, or stage have inspired us. While the graduates have already heard a few of the following statistics I'd like to share with everybody, tonight the class of 2022, coming off of 2 years of COVID-related issues, has graduated about 80% of its seniors and adds 122 more alumni to its history. We have students going places we haven't been before. Our Titans have been admitted to Tennessee State, Smith College, University of Hawaii at Manoa, Hessen College, Kentucky, and West Coast Baptist. Palo Verde seniors are in a class by themselves in our district. The class of 2022, I implore you to write your next great chapter in this school's history. I believe in you and know that you only need an opportunity to show the world what you can do. I want to leave you with this final thought. Never say never, because limitations like fear exist only in your mind. Thank you. And now we are pleased to present the Palo Verde Concert Choir under the direction of Miss Corey Peterson. right, thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce the class of 2006 Palo Verde alumnus, Victor Yates.
Palo Verde, it's good to be home. Thanks for having me back today. Love to see the class of 2022 and the opportunity to speak a little bit about what's been going on in the world today. Quick question for you all. Turn to your neighbor. How much of the human body is made up of water? I'm gonna give you 3 seconds to talk to your neighbor. Okay. I like that, 78%. All right. So the answer for the adult is 60%. Oh, I like that side. Right. But the reality is you are more than water, right? That no one goes around and says, hey, man, you're like a fish. Or when I tell you 60%, you start crying and you look to your neighbor, you look to your maybe spouse or sibling and go, I'm all H2O, I didn't know that, right? That doesn't happen. You are more than your errors. You are more than your mistakes and your shortcomings. You are more than your family. Whether that be you come from a family with finances, or you come from a family with a troubled history, or whether you come from just a good old family, you are more than your family. Class of 2022, you are also more than what you are good at. For some of you, that's your GPA, right? When I was here, I was fortunate enough to leave Palo Verde with a 3.27. And the amount of time, 16 years ago, that I've told people I've had a 3.27 might be 3.27 times. That is not who I am. I am more than my GPA. You are more than what you do. You are more than your actions. I want to leave you guys with something to think about as you go out into the real world and you go to make an impact. It's a word called hope. And today, I'm going to use it as an acronym and say that H is for hunger. Go out there and find what you are naturally curious about and you want to learn more about and go after it. O stands for opportunity. Research and look deeply into all of the opportunities that are out in the world to feed those hungers that you may have. P is for productivity. Clock work. Do good. Be productive in the things that you have a hunger for and what you found your opportunities in. And lastly, evaluate. Evaluate the hunger that you had and the opportunities and the productivity and look at that chain because it's a process of this life that we're in and it's a journey. Evaluate the end result and see if you like the outcomes. And if you like the outcomes, continue to go forth. And if you don't, hey, you could be like me and figure something else out. I switched career roles about 5 times before I landed in the ideal spot for me as an individual where I can now say I've been working in the same industry for 12 years. But 5 times prior, I didn't know where I wanted to go, and I had things that were of interest to me. And as I explored them, I saw that it wasn't a good fit for me. So, class of 2022, there's hope. Thank you.
It's with great pleasure that I present to you the class of 2022 salutatorian Mandone with a grade point average of 4.06.
Thank you, Mr. Brock. Good evening, class of 2022. Before I start, I would like to thank my family for coming out to support me, the faculty of this school for helping me these past 4 years, and my friends for making my high school years exhilarating and memorable. I would also like to thank everyone in the audience for setting time aside to attend this ceremony with us. Today, we have all gathered here to celebrate something very important. We're celebrating the start of our lives, an end to our high school years, but most importantly, we're celebrating what we've achieved. The path we took to get to where we are today has been challenging for most of us. Whether it was easy or difficult for you, we can all agree that we've made some unforgettable memories. About 4 years ago, all of us had at least one goal in mind entering high school. Some of us wanted to prepare for college, make new friends, or maybe wanted to improve ourselves. It could also be as simple as just making it through the year, which I'm sure applies to most of us. Whatever your goals were, they all share something in common. They were there to give us a reason to push through these last 4 years, and that is why we are all here, sitting among our fellow graduates. Throughout these past years, so much has happened. We faced many challenges that had to be overcome, from figuring out what the best clothes to wear for the day is, to rushing to complete an assignment the night before it was due. Let's not forget the year when we had to do online school because of, you know what? The online school year was an interesting period, because we were able to get away with so many things, like sleeping in, playing video games while in our online classes, and easily getting answers to an assignment. It was also a period where we felt isolated from our friends, unmotivated to anything, and maybe even questioned if the world would ever get back to normal. Despite this, we were able to adapt to our situation and continue to persevere and believe in ourselves. We knew that we were going to make it through these uncertain times. I hope that the school year has left everyone feeling a sense of normality, as well as getting the chance to reunite with people you haven't seen in what might have felt like centuries for some of us. As this speech is coming to an end, I'd like you all to listen to these last few sentences. I want to congratulate each and every one of you for making it this far. Don't think of this achievement to be insignificant. Be proud of the amount of work you put into this diploma. You know, Robert Collier once said that success is the sum of small effort, repeated day in and day out. Your effort and your determination to graduate is something that should be recognized today, and you should be proud of this achievement. I hope tonight was a night to be remembered, and I know you will persevere through all the hardship you might face later on in life. I want to leave you with one last thing as you go on this amazing journey ahead of you. I want you to always remember that life is like a sandwich. No matter which way you flip it, the bread always comes first. Thank you.
Thank you, man. It's with great pleasure that I present to you the class of 2022 valedictorian, Ella Badinger, with a GPA of 4.37.
All right, well, I cannot top that, but I just want to say congratulations to the class of 2022. Thank you all very much.
Introduce the first student speaker selected to give a speech to the class of 2022, Cassandra Rosales. Will you please approach the microphone and give your speech entitled Just Keep Swimming?
Wonder. In the last moments of me as a senior to becoming a graduate student, what would young me think of all of this? I think she would be confused. Because what does it mean? I would tell her that I made it. Since we needed to have, it motivated me, strengthened me, and now I can say we made it. I do not know about you, but I feel this is too quick. I remember learning how to ride a bike, and then suddenly, I was filling out college applications. I was feeling like this was such a memorable honor, though, because it just shows that I made it. So many times, though, I wanted to quit, because I wanted to stay a kid forever. I mean, no one wants to fill out taxes or do financial stuff. No one wants to piece out mortgages or put your mind into something. But we have to move forward. We do not dwell on the past because we will never have time to experience the future. I remind myself of the Finding Dory quote, just keep swimming. No matter how many challenges she was going to face, the failures she would suffer, she indeed kept swimming. My junior year was a struggle to my mental health. COVID struck and we were placed in front of a computer. I felt unmotivated and wanted to quit. I wanted to see my friends. I didn't want to worry about getting this disease and spread it amongst the people I care about. To you, or to some people, it might have felt like the greatest year to sleep in or play video games. To others, it felt like being in a cage. I felt unproductive, and I had to focus twice as much because the audio was awful and the subtitles did not help some of the time. I felt I was not going to pass this hurdle. I was expecting to pass with good grades, but my hope was at an end. I had taken college classes as well and felt like I was being drained every second of my life. Though that year taught me something, it taught me that things are going to get worse before they start getting better. You may feel horrible, and it is likely you're going to feel even worse. But then it will get better. Just keep moving, just keep swimming. This was my first year at Palo Verde. I chose this school because not only because I live close here, but also because the student body is diverse. It's difficult, really, to be friends with people who have already formed their groups. So I was lucky I found some funny people. What I noticed from this school was not only did I come across good people, but good teachers who were really passionate about their job. I noticed some people were hardworking, some more carefree than others, some more with a bit of pep in their step, some who are timid yet thoughtful. There is a beautiful mix of personalities this year, different perspectives about certain things, different stories. This place was decorated with colors by you. Life will challenge you because it fears your existence. It fears your patience, your strong will to anything you overcome. You guys push and life pushes back. You will fall over, but get back up because backing down means defeat. You can be a loser though, but don't stand down because it's not the end of the world. Don't be scared to make a mistake or you won't be able to fully experience your time here. When you lose, learn and adapt. Keep pushing, keep moving, keep swimming, keep existing. You made it this far, it'd be a shame if you stopped now, despite the obstacles you conquered. So I end a speech here. I would like to thank my mom, my dad, my sisters, my brothers, my uncles, my aunts, my nieces, my nephews, my grandpa and grandma for being there for me and mentoring me. Thank you guys. And you guys should thank your parents too, anybody who helped you, because, well, you made it this far, am I right?
Right.
Most importantly, keep existing, because your existence yourself is a beautiful thing. Thank you, graduates, for passing this hurdle and being here. May you all know that we made it. Go, graduates.
Thank you. I would like to introduce the second student selected to give a speech to the class of 2022. Alex Peterson, will you please approach the microphone and give your speech entitled Waiting to Be Known?
Parents, peers, and others, thank you for coming. Tonight, my confrère, we celebrate the end of our high school careers, a genuinely monumental point in our lives that will be the starting line for the many and vast experiences that currently wait on hold for us. Whether you plan on continuing your schooling or heading into the workforce, the fact remains that you succeeded here and now. Tonight, we set aside our differences, cast away our old anxieties, and prepare for the daunting task of life laid in front of us. Faster than any of us could have truly imagined, we find ourselves leaving Palo Verde. To those of you here who believe you do not belong, I'm here to tell you that you do. From benchmark testing to lunchline crushes, each and every one of us has proven ourselves to be a Palo Verde student. A student that is resilient in the face of opposition, determined to persevere, and insatiably eager to move forward. A student who is in fact no longer a student, but rather an alumnus. I ask you all here to look back 654 days to August 10th, 2020, the start of the class of 2022's junior year, a year that brought to most of us despair, depression, and an unease that most of us had never felt before. Even for those who managed to succeed, there is no denying the social and mental effects of the pandemic on high school students across the country. For me and many others, the only way we got through our junior year was our friends and club activities. It demonstrated to us that we were not alone in hardship, and that sometimes we just need a shoulder to cry on and an activity to immerse ourselves in. Personally, if I had not had my friends on voice call for hours a day, I think I would have gone mad from isolation. We can now look back on those days and see how we somehow avoided a global catastrophe while continuing our education. As my speech and my high school career come to a close, I'd like to leave you some advice. It's normal to have anxiety, and it's normal to be scared, but even when you think there's no one out there who understands, there actually is. Unlike the past 18 or so years of your life, the world is open to you, and it's up to you whether you're open to it. And as the late, great Carl Sagan said, somewhere, something incredible is waiting to be known. So to you of class of 2022, I say go find it. Thank you.
Thank you, Alex. At this time, our speakers may take their seats with the class of 2022. Hello, my name is Michelle Weisbrod, Assistant Principal of Operations and Activities. It is our pleasure to honor to present you with these top 25 students to be recognized for their academic achievements. I will read each student's name, beginning with number 25. As your name is called, please come forward and take your seat of honor. Number 25, Kennedy M. Pearson, 3.395. Number 24, Lee Barber, 3.426. Number 23, Christopher Duran, 3.435. Number 22, Sierra A. Alegria, 3.524. Number 21, Isaac G. Reyes, 3.531. Number 19, Asefwi Said, 3.537. Number 19, Jamal, 3.537. Number 18, Yetsamani Follet Chua, 3.542. Number 17, Uamani Josarin, 3.575. Number 16, Adrian M. Hernandez, 3.6. Number 15, Antonio E. Martinez, 3.636. Number 14, Cassandra A. Rosales, 3.661. Number 13, Giselle Romero, 3.692. Number 12, Arlene Gallardo, 3.783. Number 11, Corina R. Doyle, 3.786. Number 10, Riley Jasmine Jackson, 3.881. Number 3, Tifa E. Garcia, 3.972.
L. De La Cruz. Corina Rose Doyle. Giselle Romero. Arlene Gallardo. Giselle Romero. Ka- Cassandra Abigail Rosales. Adrian Miguel Hernandez. Yetsamani Fuye Chua. Jamal Jamal. Asifue Saidi. Isaac Gabriel Reyes. Sierra Alexandra Alegria. Christopher Kabakapa Duren. Lee Raphael Barber Jr. Kennedy May Pearson.
Alana Brianne Gonzalez Abad. John James Adams. Rashid Alboke. Jasmine Ashella Ortiz. Cody Draven Bishop. Tavonda Gwinnett Watkins Madison. Perla Ulyssa Barrios Acuna. William Henry Baum. Tamara Nicole Marie Beal. Tiana Danae Booker. David Henry Brake Jr. Kelvin Neville Briggs. DeAndre Wade Brown. Zaniah Lee Burdick. I know. Zaniah Lee Burdick. Sky Renee Cavallato. Kamoya Kaya Coleman. Jaime Corona. Juliana Cortez. Jose Alian Cote. O. Fox Deanda. Emmanuel Christian Delgado. Santi Nevea Dixon. Jonathan Daniel Fogel. Joseph David Foster. John Abdul Gavijada Renteria. Gavijada Renteria. Takes me twice sometimes. Yusuf Garbia. Riley Asher Giles. Malia Ariana Gomez. Sophia Alejandra Greenwell. Andrea Guerrero Hernandez. Destiny Azare Hands. Christian Ray Harrison. Santiago Saeed Hernandez Guzman. Juan David Hernandez Martinez. Cassidy Elaine Hilliard. William Dean Hirth Hamilton. Mary Howard. Jessica Madeline Igulu. Isabella Louise Klein.
Xavier Andrew MacMiller. Nicole Alex Martinez. Layla Diane Massey. Ethan Luis Matthew. Bianca Renee Maddie. Ezekias Bynesum. Karina Ogo Reynosa Meza. Deanna Kate Mixter. Alejandro Montaño. Taylor Lynn Moore. Natalia Moreno Riascos. Heaven Lee Miles. Axel Paul Oro Quintero. Sophia Chanel Palomo. Emery Jr. Pambood. Isaac Paramo. Amelia Kathleen Parrott. Brianna Michelle Pareda. Paulina Jasmine Perez Sesma. Martin Ponce. Connor Martin Roberts. Saira Anaí Rosales. Wyatt Alexander Ross. Alessandro Jeremy Duane Scott. Donovan Eric Schindler. Naomi Smiley. Emily K. Smith. Arthur Miguel Stevens. Danielle Lauren Straub. Olivia Joy Tabor. Melvin Thompson. Nicholas Renee Diaz Torres. Ashton S. Urquijo. Anthony DeAndre Valenzuela. Isaias Valenzuela. Dalia Vargas Velasco. Benjamin Michael Wakefield. Elijah Thomas Wendt. Xavier Cloud Wilcoxon. Sean Eric Wiley Jr. Amari Yvonne Williams. Malik Amir Williams. Alexis Mary Jane Zabel. Michaela Nevaeh Zabel. Isaiah Anthony Friend.
Okay, Mr. Lambert, honored guests, we are very proud of these students and accept them as graduates of Palo Verde Magnet High School.
Please change your tassels from right to left.
And throw your caps.
I'm okay, thank you. I can find them.
Go be with them. Go be with them.
This concludes our ceremony. Thank you all for coming. Family and friends, please join the class of 2022 on the field.